Thank you very much. Étudiants, étudiantes, ladies and gentlemen. We are in Switzerland, and that's the perfect country to talk about frontiers. Switzerland has no frontiers, because Switzerland doesn't exist. When you don't exist, you have no frontiers. And we have no people. And that is why the Swiss, because they knew 150 years ago that they had no frontiers and no people, that's why they decided to create a nation. And when the question was asked, where should Switzerland be? The answer was, Switzerland must be in the world. That is our nation. The nation is the world. My goodness, 150 years ago, that was the thinking of the Swiss people. The world will be our territory. That's where we're going to work. And then came the second question. Yeah, but how? How do we do that? And the answer was phenomenal. We will conquer the world through education. The kids, that's the future. The future is education. If we can have the best education, we will have the best new generation. And if we can get the best new generation, they will go out of Switzerland and they will conquer the world. Brilliant, brilliant. And then the question, next question, is that enough? Is that all we need? No. We need a vehicle to transport the brain. How can you transport the brain from one place to the other one of the planet? Through the best vehicle, which is the body. And the body is the vehicle of the brain. The body is nothing else. So we need the best health system in order to keep the body in the best shape possible and to transport the brain outside, around the planet. What else do we need? Was asked in this room where seven guys gathered together. What else do we need? Yes, we have no country, but we also have no people. So we will need people. Yes, we will need people. We will have a political system that is based on the differences of cultures, the differences of nationalities, and they will make us rich. We have to let them come in, and we have to integrate them, and they will develop Switzerland together with us. And that is how Switzerland became the most generous country to welcome all the foreigners. Switzerland has then built a political system that was built on what? On consensus. Why did we need a consensus? Because we need to get rid of the frustrations. And as we have so many cultures, as we have so many different languages, Switzerland has 10, 15 languages, if you include all the languages of the foreigners. Switzerland has even 10 languages or 8 languages when you take French, German, Italian, and Romance, plus the dialects. Wherever you go in Zermatt, they speak a dialect in Schweizerdeutsch, which the guy in Bern cannot understand. So all these differences, they said, we need a consensus where everybody has his word to say, where nobody leaves frustrated, because the frustration is the cancer of democracy. We see it every day. You see, I don't want to name countries now, but you see it every day. in Switzerland, there is never a frustration because we all gather and we all find the consensus. This was 150 years ago, and that's how Switzerland has developed. And thus Switzerland became the nation that Switzerland is today. And thus Switzerland exists today. Eventually, yes, they are the headquarters of Nestle. But Switzerland has become the biggest coffee producer and coffee buyer, but we don't have coffee fields. We have only maize, corn, and some nice flowers and cows. So Switzerland, today, even today, we hardly exist. We are still governed by the rule from 150 years ago, where we are outside Switzerland. And that's the strength of the country. And these people have understood it 150 years ago, when the European Union hardly starts to understand it now. We were in advance. And that is why the Swiss model is probably the model of the 21st century. And the 21st century will be the century not of me, not of you parents. It will be the century of our children that are born in 2000. And when these children will come into power when they are 35 years old or 40, that will be around 2030, 2040, then we will enter the 21st century. Because now I am not a man of the 21st century. I'm a man of the last century. And my mentality, even if I study a lot the new generation, even if I want to open my mind, even if I want to understand, I am still from the old generation. And the old generation was an imperialist generation. We were going to make wars. Europe just finished a war when I was born. And then we went to do war in Algeria and everywhere. We are born in the last century, not with the mentality of sharing, but in the mentality of getting rich by what you take from the others. And today, the challenge is to become rich through sharing. And there's a possibility to become rich by sharing. Sharing will make us rich. And if we cannot achieve to share, the 21st century will stop to exist. That's my prevision. That is what I see. But on the other hand, I am so confident in these children we have, in this new generation that is now 15 years old, 18 years old. This new generation will understand that we have to share. We have to start to share planet. Who is sharing planet? Nobody. Everybody is taking from planet what planet can give us. But there's a limit. And planet Earth is so small. It's a miniature. It's so small in the universe. We have to take care of planet. We have to share the climate. We have to share the resources. There is a new mentality that is not the one I have, because I'm born in the imperialist time. Even if I try to understand, I still drive with a 12-cylinder engine. At least I admit my errors. And when you admit, in the Catholic, when you say to the priest, you did a sin, he say, okay, no problem. You say da 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 da, then you can start again. That's the beauty of the Catholic religion. you can do, and then you rip, and start again. the mafiosis, they are, you see them every Sunday in the south of Italy coming out of the church, and that's it. So the 21st century will be the century of sharing. It will also be the century where there will be no frontiers anymore. The frontier will be planet. That will be our frontier, planet. And planet is rich of different cultures. Planet is rich of different religions. Planet is rich of different people. And all these people coming together will make us rich. And the sharing makes rich. It's very difficult to understand that sharing makes rich. Very difficult. But you have to try. And if anybody of you have ever tried, he will notice that it has made him rich. And I give you just an example. My oldest son is now 34 years old. He has been 12 years in China. He speaks Chinese, Mandarin. He has a fiancé, Chinese. And he will get married, and he will have Chinese children. That makes me rich. It makes the name Biver rich. Because suddenly, the Biver family opens to China. And I will have grandchildren and go every Sunday with two Chinese grandchildren. That will make me rich. That is no frontier. The world is ours. And there's one thing in life that has no frontier. It's art. Art is worldwide. Art is everywhere. And art has no language, has no religion. Art is just the expression of love of an artist. Music has no nationality. When the Beatles, on the 7th of July, 1967, released the famous song called All You Need Is Love, that was world. That had no nationality. It was not British. It was just a song, All You Need Is Love, that the whole world has shared, that the whole world has sung. So music, art, is universal. Now, why? How come that art and music or painting is universal? Picasso is universal. Mozart is universal. No frontier for art. Why? Because art is love. It's passion. Passion is love. And love is universal. Love is everywhere the same. Every religion, today we still have some wars because of different religions, but every religion at the base has the same claim. God is love and God is eternal. If God is love and love is eternal, if God is love and God is eternal, then love is eternal. And love is everywhere. And that is what we have to understand. Love is our future. And love means sharing. Sharing is an act of love. Respect, to respect nature, to respect foreigners, to respect the different cultures. What is respect? Respect is love. And last but not least, in life, we all do mistakes. And you students, I beg you, do a lot of mistakes when you are young. Because the mistakes you do when you are older are sometimes have more worse consequences as if you do them when you are young. But we all learn through the mistake. The mistake, whatever the school tells you, the mistake is a learning process. And each mistake which you don't repeat, you come closer to wiseness. You come closer to success. Don't repeat the same mistake twice. Now, how many mistakes can a normal person do in life? Maybe 300, 400. That's it. And then you're at the end. So if you start very young to do a lot of mistakes, very quickly you are at the end of the mistakes. And very quickly you reach a certain wiseness or become experienced. Now, if the mistake is or belongs to the learning process, then we must forgive mistakes. We must forgive. Forgiveness, sharing, and respecting are three appearances of love. Love is not just between papa and mama, because even today you can have two papa and two mama. So love is also no frontier, thanks God. No frontier anymore for love. But the love means also sharing, respecting, and forgiving. And that is the ethic behavior of the future. And that is why I accepted to come today to share with you this vision of the future. Because if you children, if you young students, you are the future of our planet. Not your teacher, not your mother, your father, and not me. The future is in your hands. And that is a phenomenal challenge to have the 21st century in your hands. And you can shape the 21st century and you can shape your own destiny. My goodness, how wonderful. What a phenomenal challenge. You shape your own future, and by doing that, you shape the future of planet. That is your mission. That is why we love you. That is what we expect you to do. Thank you very much.